Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Vikas Nitzer. In today's video, we're going to see how to identify the type of filter from a given transfer function and plot its magnitude and phase response. Okay, so let us start the programming. So initially I have taken basic commands. So we know that in a transfer function is a ratio of zero and pole. So we have to define their numerator and denominator coefficients. So I will write numerator in bracket 1, 0. Then I will declare pole coefficient, that is denominator, equal to, for example, 1 minus 0.9. Then I want to plot. So I will write, for example, is a one row, three column, location first. So then I will take a z plane because I want to plot their z plane in a form of zero and poles. So I will write z plane, that is a numerator comma denominator, bracket complete, next line. So I will give the title in bracket is a pole 0 plot. Okay, so next I will plot their magnitude response, that is, for example, omega equal to 0 as to pi divided by 32 as to pi. Okay, you can change this omega and you can see the whatever the effects on the waveform of magnitude and phase response. Then the first thing I have to plot, that is a magnitude response. So for that I will use the command frequency z command, FREQZ in bracket, that is a numerator comma denominator comma, that is frequency omega. Then I will find whatever the magnitude of the transfer function, that is absolute of h. So it will find the whatever the magnitude response. Then I will take the phase equal to angle in bracket h. Then I will take subplot, one row, three column, location second. Then I will plot magnitude. I will take x as a omega divided by pi comma and y as a magnitude, bracket complete. Then I will write a title is nothing but magnitude plot for, basically I am designing IR low pass filter, IR low pass filter, bracket complete. Once again I will copy these things, just paste here. Just I will change the subplot 1, 3, 3. Here I will write omega divided by pi comma phase. Here I will write phase plot for IR low pass filter. I will write in capital low pass filter, low pass filter. So basically this program I have designed for the IR low pass filter. So through this transfer function, you can design or you can identify that this is nothing but low pass filter. So how you can identify? So just save this program. Okay, you can see the output. So first figure is nothing but pole zero plot, second is nothing but magnitude plot for IR filter, low pass filter, and this is a phase plot for IR low pass filter. So if you see the pole zero plot, in that case, whenever the pole is present at this position, means is nothing but in a digital filter, the work of pole is nothing but that it will pass the frequency, and the meaning of zero is nothing but it will stop the frequency. So basically, so whatever the frequency is here, means actual low pass frequency is there, means at this position it will pass. If the pole is present at this position, that is nothing but it's a high pass filter. So that we can see in the next video. But initially, whenever the pole is present at this position, that is nothing but that this will pass the low pass frequency. You can identify the filter from the transfer function, and this the meaning of this is nothing but that it block the whatever the high frequency. Why? Because at this position is nothing but the lower frequency. It will go at this position, means the frequency goes on increasing. At that position, the frequency become a maximum. The same thing is here up to this position. So the pole is present at this position means what? The pole is passing that particular frequency, and zero is present here. The meaning is what? That blocking the high frequency. So that's why this filter is nothing but IR low pass filter. So like this, you can easily identify the filter from a transfer function. If you want to take a printout of this, then simply go to the edit option and just go to the figure properties, then simply go to the figure color and just make the white color. So you can take a directly printout. Okay, so in that case you will get a better printout. So I hope now you understand how to identify the type of filter from a given transfer function. So in next video we are going to see the IR high pass filter. So if you like this video, then please subscribe my YouTube channel, because lots of people are watching my video but still they are not subscribed my channel. So please subscribe my channel, like my videos, and if you have any doubt, then please comment on my video. So thank you.